call a gang, man. Pop the 30, looking for the Percocet 10. Crack my iPhone 10, last night on the Zan. Keep doing show, then I want the bank in. And now we rapping on trap. B dog, no cap. That 40 on me to protect me. All these niggas down bad. Remember, I ain't had nothing. I ain't never going back.
Let me tell you something.
Talk to me.
Nigga not even into these made up bitches no more. Nigga want the women with natural flaws.
Right.
Everything that's natural is better. So when you make a mistake, don't fix it immediately. Cause that shit might make you.
Right.
That one mistake. That's how I got on with that rap shit. This shit a mistake.
When did you start rapping? Like, when did you get on it? And did you start in Atlanta?
Yeah, I started rapping in Atlanta. I was rapping in New York when I was young and shit on some battle rap shit. That shit was boogie woogie as hell. But I was battle rapping though. Like, I was rapping, I was doing something.
How old were you when you actually came to Atlanta to start rapping?
When I first came to Atlanta, I was 13.
So are you still mobile back and forth rapping? And because you are an aspiring rapper, so obviously you're traveling back and forth.
Yeah, what you mean, like, what I started off doing the rap shit?
Oh. Well, when you came here, is that when you actually took it serious in Atlanta?
Nah, see, I ain't really want to do no rap or none of that. I was just back and forth. Like, my whole family from Brooklyn. But we came out here, you know, your mom want to have a good life and all that type shit. And when we came out here, we ran right back into the hood. So, you know, I was getting kicked out of school and shit. So I went back to New York. Mm. Like, I rode on Greyhound. Like,
do you have any siblings?
Yeah, I got a whole bunch of siblings. Cause I got it. See, like my family, we, you know, even your stepbrothers and, you know, it's like my real brothers. But my brothers, I got three little brothers.
Okay.
Three little brothers.
So what's your background? Are you guys like?
Oh, well, you know, my mom and them, we got West Indian in our family, you know, Jamaican and shit. Mm-hmm. But I'm black.
Right. Like, so tell me, explain to me, what's Street Execs? Street Execs is this a label that you're signed to?
Nah. Street Execs is just the first goddamn label that even paid attention to a nigga. And I'm just loyal, you feel me?
And who owns Street Execs? Is this
shit, goddamn. From what I know the owner Al, and it was Charlie Rocket. Y'all can look him up. That's one of my close friends.
Right.
And then you got Technique. So it's called and those the three. And then you got big people behind it. with the main one, 2 Chainz, you know what I'm saying? Right. So like, that's how that go. But from what I know, I think it's definitely Al, Charlie, and Technique.
So how, being that, you know, you are a part of the streets here in Atlanta, was it pretty difficult to get recognition in street execs? Being that you just also started rapping as well?
Yeah, it's still hard getting recognition. I'm lit in the city, you know, because, like, niggas know me from, you know, like, jail, from the streets, like, from gang banging, from trapping. So, you know, that would niggas know me from the streets. So,
right.
Even when I get on the stage, and a nigga might, I ain't even gonna lie, like, before my shit was even hard. I might have some lame ass shit, but nigga was still rocking to a G because they see I'm trying to rap.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a real street nigga. That's why I be on some real, like, pushing up on tight nigga versus social media. Like, I'd rather push up on you because I know once I push up on you, you know, it's relationships, it's everything. Like,
right. Is it more of a connection, more of a...
Yeah, nigga could talk all that shit on the internet or whatever, on the phone and all that shit. That shit don't mean nothing. When you inside a nigga face, nigga could feel what going on. Like, I could look a nigga in his face and know if you lame or know if you goddamn on some real nigga shit, if I could sting you, you feel me? Like, I ain't even on that, but that's just how I used to be.
So what's your message in your music? Like, what?
Shit, goddamn stand on top of the furniture.
Stand on top of the furniture?
Stand on top of the furniture.
And what do you mean by that?
When nigga hear my shit, they gonna stand on top of the furniture.
Like,
yeah.
Rock out and shit.
Rock out, pour the lick out, all that shit. We fucking up your club every time my music come on.
Damn.
I'm telling you.
So what about the insurance?
And we gonna have good money. And get what? Get what? Get what? We ain't tripping on none of that shit. We about go ahead and buy you a nice little sofa and all that shit. Whatever you got going on, we'll pay for that shit again. But when we inside the club, we standing on top of the furniture. We fucking up the VIP till they free VIP.
Hey.
Just like that. Free my boy VIP. VIP really is the nigga that introduced me to Street Is That. I ain't gonna lie. Like, I already knew niggas inside Street Is That, but, like, home was tied in. He the one that made me do music. They used to run a showcase
okay.
every week.
What, out here?
Yeah, it was at Harlem Nights. It was called, what that shit was, Skin? Who got the juice?
Oh, I heard of that.
Okay,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, basically, who got the juice was, they do it for 4 weeks, and you gotta win. Like, if you win, you get, like, it's basically at the end, on the 4th week, everybody that been winning through the month, y'all all go against each other.
Oh, wow.
And then you get to win the trophy and $1,000. So, damn. I did that shit on some old, I wasn't even trying type shit. I won $1,000 and then I won the trophy, and that's kind of like, got me that serious.
So let me hear something, spit something like one of your verses or something real quick so I can know like what. Let us know what you got. Put you on the spot.
You going to just
all the flaws, all the gold.
She going to just try to sight. I'm a real.
Let's hear it.
Listen, baby. Let me tell you. Listen. Before I even say anything, I'm a real. What kind of artist do you call that?
Speak up a little.
Vibey.
Okay.
So.
What does that mean?
That means that. Maybe if everybody was in this bitch freestyling, maybe I would just freestyle.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, when I be making songs, I don't even know what the fuck I be saying. I gotta go listen to the song because I'm really just saying, I never wrote a song ever.
So you just go off the top and you just...
Yeah.
What's one of your lines that you came up with and, you know, you be like, damn, that shit's hard. Or just...
We can't do it together, but... I do it better. We can't do it together. I do it better.
That's what you said? Yeah. We can't do it together. I do it. And what does that mean?
I'm trying to make a duck pull a truck.
You trying to make a duck pull a truck?
I'm kicking shit, swallowing spit.
You kicking shit so you don't spit.
No, I'm kicking shit and swallowing spit.
Oh, you kicking shit and swallowing.
And trying to make a duck pull a truck. Exactly. That what the fuck going on. Do you understand me? That's one
I'm
of my songs.
To.
That one of my songs. That's my single. You see how you don't understand?
Oh, I like that.
You ain't going. See, guess what? You weren't supposed to understand.
Clearly.
That's my single that's coming out right now.
Damn. That shit threw me off.
I know it threw you off. This shit real. This shit authentic.
Listen.
I'm working.
I like that.
I gotta go do a feature. Forget how much I'm doing the feature for.
How much?
$200. It's all good.
So listen, but you know that's a good thing.
Feature.
But that's a good thing.
But I'm not mad.
People can't even get features, period. So you understand, it's a good thing. You're making money. At the end of the day, it's only gonna get more and more and more. You tack on more
I'm
zeros.
Lit.
Exactly, and you just started.
Yeah, I'm lit.
You're good.
If you ask anybody, any big rapper that know me, any rapper, any of that shit that know me, they're gonna tell you, but I didn't even know Butter rap. Hey, Young Rose. When you first met me, did you know I rap?
Hell
no,
you said nothing about it.
Okay.
How do you feel about him rapping?
How I feel about rapping? Do you understand me?
See that? See how you see that? Let me tell you, I ain't with all of that. I'm not gonna say that, cause you know, I fuck with Technique. Technique told me to stop saying that I ain't with the rap shit and none of that. Cause I do want to be a rapper.
Right.
I don't want to just be out here trapping and all that shit. I'm trying to make some motherfucking money off
this
rap.
So what are you saying?
So I say that to say, I'm on my rap shit now. So like, niggas gonna see more of this and you gonna see me more in the studio doing, you know what I'm saying?
You like that.
Yeah, I just had a daughter.
Congratulations, what's her name?
Layla. Olivia Victoria Ellaby.
Oh, congratulations.
It spells out love.
Whoa, that's beautiful.
Yeah, we going.
Layla,
we going
Olivia
big.
Victoria.
We going big on the dub. What? Well, you just came from New York, Yams Day.
Yeah. How was that?
Yeah, check the footage out.
Yeah.
True with the big, I fuck with everybody, don't get it twisted.
Yeah.
But yeah, you see what's going on.
We're gonna post that on the interview.
When we pull it up, get what? Don't folks see what's going on. They're like, yeah, them niggas look, they don't know who the star is. That's how we pulling up. You don't know who the star is. Everybody fresh. God damn, I can't wait till I go big on these niggas.
Alright, anything else you want to tell your fans?
Hey, I don't want to say nothing else, but follow me everywhere, Butter Getting Cheese. Go watch my videos on YouTube, Butter Getting Cheese. I'm the only Butter Getting Cheese there is.
The only.
If you see another one, they ain't the real one. We got real one shit going on, True, Street is X, and a whole bunch of new bunch of shit coming on, man. I got my little homies about to come home. Yeah, free the fucking gang, man. Yeah. Free the fucking gang, man. Yeah. I love you to death, Chad. Yeah.
We love you.
Yeah. Rest in peace to all the homies. Guess what? Nah, see, Shawty don't know how big this is, but guess what? The interview right here might make you big, baby.
Big.
Just because I don't even do this shit. I'm just feeling real good. I'm feeling like I should get on my rap shit. I'm feeling like I should network a little bit more.
Me in here.
And now you got this. I got the real one, Understand Me, and Down Bad. Those are the three singles I'm pushing.
And what's your social media name so we can find you?
Butter Getting Cheese on everything. Ain't no Butter Getting Cheese. Spell that shit fucked up. That shit is still gonna pop up. It's BUTTAGITTIN cheese.
Thank you. We appreciate you.
You're welcome.
This is only the beginning. We're gonna have more of this.
Yeah, I fuck with you, man. I fuck with everybody trying to work.
I like
appreciate
that.
You coming out here. They don't even know it's 1 o'clock in the morning.
They don't need to know, but it's just the beginning.
I salute you.
Good day.
And you gonna make it.
You already know.
Facts.
But shout out to Street is X. We in here. It's just the beginning. Tap in. Amped Up Live. Thank you.
Street.